On August 4, we welcome back an artist that hasn't been at Brit in some time, but he is, I think, one of the visionary musicians alive today. That is Edgar Meyer. Edgar is one of the great bass players to have ever lived. He is a person who transformed the concept and the very definition of what a double bass actually is, from kind of a large instrument that usually fills out the orchestra's sound to a true solo instrument that can play virtually anything in any style. He also remarkably connected the world of folk music and Americana and bluegrass to the world of classical music, and he's transcended both worlds to create a sound for himself as a composer for the double bass that is unique and extremely attractive. People love Edgar, and for very good reason. So Edgar's coming to Brit in two capacities. One, as a composer of a new orchestra piece that does not actually feature him as a soloist. It's a purely orchestral work that he just wrote, so it's really off the presses, and very few people have had the opportunity to hear it yet. And then the other piece that he's playing is his own concerto, not the one that he did last time at Brit some years ago, but a concerto that is also quite rarely played, his E major concerto, that involves not just the double bass as a soloist, but all kinds of unusual large, low instruments like bass flute and contrabass clarinet. We're super excited to present this piece at Brit. I think it's an absolute masterpiece, and it's rarely played. So we're going to make this into something of hopefully a tradition. And then the second half of the program is also American. And this is another connection to the whole kind of Leonard Bernstein element that runs through the entire season. A great friend and constant colleague of Leonard Bernstein's, Aaron Copland, who perhaps more than any other composer defined what we consider to be the American sound. You hear a work of Copland's like Billy the Kid or Appalachian Spring that we're playing on this program, or the Fanfare for the Common Man, and you know that that is immediately American. And Appalachian Spring is one of the great American masterpieces. It was originally a ballet, and in this version, we're playing most of the music that was originally heard in the ballet, not just the shorter suite that people are familiar with. And this piece really creates such an American and beautiful kind of idea of spirit. The piece revolves around a tune that you ultimately hear later on in the work. It's called Simple Gifts. And that Simple Gifts song is so much at the heart and soul of what Copland saw as the vision for the piece, a kind of profound, deep, but simple Americana that brings us all together. It's the perfect piece to play on this program.